Hey guys, so today I wanted to talk to you about washing my brushes. And somewhere around here I'm going to show you a clip of how I wash them, but one of the most important things that I wanted to talk to you about is the tools that I use to wash my brushes. And these are two DIYs, kind of like a knockoff of some high-end things. And the first DIY that I have is a knockoff, that sounds kind of bad, but it's a DIY for this Sigma rubber brush thing. And I've received this when I bought some of my brushes, and it's got, you know, it's a rubber thingy and it's got different, it's texturized, right? So you kind of like, you know, wet your brush and all that stuff and rub it through there, and that'll help kind of remove the product off. The DIY for that is this, and it's so simple to do. I am gonna try to find both the links to the DIYs that I have two, so that you can see the original video, but I mean, they're so simple that, you know, you can just do them. But this is like a plastic plate from like the dollar store or Target. I think that's where I got this one from. And these are, you get your glue gun, and then you do different things. You can do dots, you can do swirls, you can do lines, whatever you want, really. I find that the dots are a little bit more, I don't want to say abrasive, but they do kind of, because they are more texturized, they do get a little bit more of the product off. And so I find this so useful. It's been through so many washes with my brushes, and it's awesome. You're gonna see here what I do, but basically I have like a little bowl, and I mix a little bit of either Dawn soap or Castile soap, and a little bit of olive oil, and a little bit of, I add a little teeny tiny bit of alcohol or a little teeny tiny bit of tea tree oil. So to kind of sanitize, you know? But anyway, but you don't have to add that. I think the Dawn is disinfectant, antibacterial, if I'm not mistaken. But anyway, so yeah, this is what I use, okay? So easy to do. The thing that I am most excited to show you guys, because I think this was like so smart, and I did this a long time ago, and I had been looking forever all over YouTube, all over the blogosphere, for a DIY for this. And I wanted a really good method to dry my brushes. I tried many different things, and this one just, it was so smart, and as soon as I saw it, I was like, why didn't I think of that? And it's basically a stand. And we can get these from Walmart or even the dollar store. That's where I found. This isn't one from the dollar store. This is from Walmart, but I have seen them at the dollar store. And it's just one of those shelves that you put in your kitchen shelves or bathroom shelves, whatever. And then I bought a bag of rubber bands, and I just put them all over vertically and horizontally. And this is what it comes up as. And this is like how it holds the brushes. So after I wash my brushes, I kind of dip them in the solution and I rinse them and I take all the soap off. And then I kind of have a little towel next to me, and I'll kind of spot dry them a little bit. And then I'll stick them from underneath. Don't do it from up here because you'll ruin your bristles. Do it from down here, and then you kind of stick it up like this. Okay? And it's set. The same like with the other one, you're done, and then you stick it through. Okay, the good thing about this is only like $5, if not less. You can get it $2 if you get this thing at the dollar store. But you can put as many different brushes from all kinds of sizes. This is an eyeshadow brush, and can kind of like stick it in there. I think this is way better and cheaper than the drying tree. I can't remember what it's called actually, but you know, you've seen them all over. It's like a plastic thing that has silicone circles. I think it only has space for 10 or 12. You can put like so many more brushes here. You can put them from all different sizes. This is like a teeny tiny eyeliner brush, and you see like it holds perfectly, like it will not fall. And you, like after I'm done, I, you know, put them all in there and then I set them to dry. I usually put them somewhere where there's a little bit of sun so that it kind of speeds up the drying process, but it's awesome. And I think it is so useful, and these people are so smart to create those things. And I would not purchase anything else because these things work so amazingly well. And yeah, that's my video. I will see you in the next one. Okay, bye.